ministro per passo.
Who's this user 3030? Who's that user 3030? Enter by your name, user 30. User 3030. First, can you remove user 3030? I don't know who's that. Thank you. Good afternoon, students. Audible?
Yes, sir. Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon to everybody. So, in last report, how to find out the rank and how to find out the number of solutions to any system of linear equations. It may be homogeneous or non-homogeneous. Discuss that. So based on by using the concept rank of a matrix, we can find out the number of the solutions. It may be unique solution, or it may be infinite solution, or it may be sometimes it may not have any solution also. So that thing you can conclude by using the rank of a matrix. So just anyone of you, just to tell me how you will find out the number of linear equations quickly. Anyone of you? Number of linear equations. How will decide the number of solutions? For example, if it is homogeneous, means what do you have to check? For homogeneous system of linear equations, in which case it will be having infinite solutions, and in which case having
less than n.
For rank of a, if it is less than n, it will be having infinite solutions. And what about unique solution?
When rank of a is equal to n.
When rank of a is equals to n, then it will be having
unique solutions.
Unique solution, right? So when you come into non-homogeneous system of linear equations, what are the options?
Consistent, inconsistent.
Consistent and inconsistent. So in consistent, so there will be two choices. One is either it may be
unique, and
it will be infinite. Right. So when, in which case it will be infinite solution? Yes. If you want to say it is having infinite solution, means what do you have to show? The condition. What is the condition?
Rank of A is to B is equals to rank of A is, if that is less than the unknown, don't we say N is a
unique solution if it is less than N?
Oh, not if it is less than N, that's infinite solution, no sir.
Yeah, if it is less than N, it will be having infinite solution. If it is equals to N, then it will be having
unique solution.
In case rank of the augmented matrix, if it is not equals to the rank of the matrix A, if it is different, then it will be having no solution, that is inconsistent equation. So next concept is eigenvalues and eigenvectors. We discussed in last classes rank of a matrix, how to find out the rank of a matrix by using row equivalence or column. After that, we discussed system of linear equations also. So inconsistent, there will be two types, determinant or indeterminate, that is nothing but unique solution or infinite solution. And then for the Cramer's rule, it's not that much applicable, but you can apply Cramer's rule. If you want to find out the solution, means you should find out the inverse. It only will take more time to find out by using Cramer's rule. So Gauss elimination, Gauss Jordan, so no need to find out the solution, because you are going to find out just how many solutions will be there. Either it will be unique solution or infinite solution, no solution. That much, if you know the shortcuts, means that will be enough. Based on linear system of equations, it may be homogeneous or non-homogeneous. So next thing is eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So eigenvalues and eigenvectors is nothing but, so first you have to find out the, consider the one equation, determinant of A minus lambda equals zero. So this equation is nothing but characteristic equation. So determinant of A minus lambda, A is nothing but any rank of a matrix of order N. And I is nothing but identity matrix of same order. Whatever A matrix will be there, the same order, you have to consider the identity matrix. And here, in eigenvalues and eigenvectors, it should be square matrix. So that means the number of rows should be equals to number of columns. So in that case, if you are going to find out the eigenvalues, means you should find out the roots of the equation, the roots of the equation. Determinant of A minus lambda equals zero. So this determinant of A minus lambda equals to zero is nothing but characteristic equation. And the roots of the, so once if you expand that determinant, means is it PDF visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So once if you expand that determinant, means you'll get the one polynomial. So it depends on the order of the matrix A. So if it is having matrix of order 2, means you'll get the quadratic equation. In case if you considered 3x3 matrix, that is order 3 matrix, means you will get, if you considered 4x4 matrix, means you will get biquadratic equation. And you know how to find out the roots of the any polynomial, right? So that roots of the characteristic equation is nothing but characteristic roots or eigenvalues. Is it clear? So what you have to remember, means just you have to remember this one anyway, you have to remember determinant of A minus lambda equals to zero. The roots of this equation is nothing but characteristic roots. The equation is nothing but characteristic equation. So characteristic values. So here lambda is nothing but any constant. It may be negative or plus, anything. So you are going to, so in case if you consider some N by N matrix, means, so A minus lambda means if you multiplied I to the identity matrix, for example, just I'll consider the one matrix 1 0 0 1. So this is the identity matrix of order 2. So you consider one matrix A as some 1 2 3 4. Okay, so if it is the matrix 1 2 3 4, that means 2x2 matrix, means, so you have to consider determinant of this one, determinant of A minus lambda into this one. So if you multiplied lambda to the identity matrix, means it will become only diagonal elements will replace by lambda. Remaining thing will be zero. So that means we can write this one as 1 minus lambda. So if you are just, you are subtracting matrix lambda 0, 0 lambda from the matrix 1, 2, 3, 4. It will become 1 minus lambda 0, 0, not 0, this one is 2. and this one is 3, and this will become 4 minus lambda. So that means, so just you have to subtract the, just you have to subtract the lambda to the principal diagonal elements. So this one you have to equate it to 0. Now you have to expand this determinant. You know how to expand the determinant, just you have to. So if it is 2 by 2 matrix, means principal diagonal minus opposite principal diagonal elements. So that will become the determinant. In case if it is 3 by 3 matrix, that's also we know already, we discussed in first class itself how to find out the determinant of the matrix 3 by 3. So that thing you have to apply to expand this one. So after expanding, you will get equation in polynomial. So that equation is nothing but characteristic equation. Equation, this is, once if you expand this matrix determinant, means you will get the equation. So that equation is nothing but characteristic equation. And the roots of this equation, the roots of the characteristic equations is nothing but, that is the lambda I values you will get. So that values we call it as characteristic values or characteristic roots or eigenvalues. So these are the three different names for that one. So the roots of the characteristic equations are nothing but characteristic values or characteristic roots or eigenvalues. So and the vector, so once if you found out the eigenvalues, just you have to consider the one vector x not equals to 0. So that means, so just you have to consider the matrix A minus lambda I. You have to consider the matrix A minus lambda I. So in this matrix, just you have to substitute the value of lambda, whatever we got the eigenvalues, that thing you are going to substitute in this one matrix A minus lambda I. Once if you substitute, means you'll get the one vector. So and it's not unique, it may, you for a single eigenvalue you may get infinite number of vectors, that's not the unique one. So whatever you will get the non-zero vectors, that vectors we call it as eigenvectors. I have to solve one problem based on this to find out the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So any vector or characteristic vector, so corresponding to each eigenvalue lambda is nothing but eigenvectors or characteristic vectors of the matrix A. So this is Kelly-Hamilton theorem. Kelly-Hamilton theorem, what it says means, if A is the n by n matrix, then once if you expand the lambda, it means definitely you will get the polynomial. For example, if you considered n by n matrix, means the polynomial, let it be some c naught lambda power n plus c1 lambda power n minus 1 plus so on cn. So Kelly-Hamilton theorem, what it says means, definitely the matrix will satisfy this polynomial, that is c naught lambda power n plus c1 lambda power n minus 1 plus so on cn. If you replaced lambda by a, definitely it will satisfy this characteristic polynomial. So this is the definition of Kelly-Hamilton. If you are finding the eigenvalues, in that case, if you got the, what is that polynomial means, in case if you want to find out polynomial value, what is the value of that one, means you can find out it by using this Kelly-Hamilton theorem. Based on this also, I picked some few problems based on this Kelly-Hamilton theorem also. Once if you solve, then you'll come to know how we can apply this Kelly-Hamilton theorem to find out the some matrix. So you know how to find out the matrix A square. So 2 times you have to multiply. If it is 2 by 2 matrix, means you can find out the matrix multiplication easily. In case if it is 3 by 3 means some difficulty you may face, but you can find out. If you are using calci, means you can find out it easily, but in competitive exams there will be no calci is available. So if it is 4 by 4 matrix, means even you can't find out even in calci also. So that thing, in case if you want to find out some a power 4 plus a square, that value if you want to find out, means, so this is very helpful, Kelly-Hamilton theorem. So for that thing, what you can do means, just you can find out the characteristic polynomial. From in that one, if you substitute the matrix in place of eigenvalue, means then you will get the required value of the power of the matrix. It may be anything. So they will give polynomial in terms of matrix. That value you will get in this by using this Cayley-Hamilton theorem. I picked some few problems also. Then you'll come to know once if you solve means. Even you know how to find out the inverse of a matrix. Inverse of a matrix means just you can find out by checking what's that term? Singular or singular. If the matrix only you can find out the inverse of that matrix, that thing you know, and it will be given by A inverse will be equals to what is the formula? A inverse equals anybody? Adjoint of A by determinant of A. So this is the process. It will take so much time to find out the inverse of the matrix. In case if you are using the eigenvalue concept, you can find out it inverse easily because you will get this some polynomial in terms of matrix. In that one, just you have to multiply. What's that? You have to cross multiply whatever you multiply throughout that equation polynomial. Then you will get the required A inverse matrix. I into any matrix is A inverse only. Here you will get the A inverse. Remaining thing you have to simplify. Then you will get the required inverse of the matrix. So this is the one of the application of this one is of a matrix by using eigenvalues or by using Cayley-Hamilton theorem. So this is the one simple example. Just to see, I'll explain this one. So 1, 2, 3, 4 is the matrix. So just you have to find out the characteristic polynomial of this one. So then once if you got the characteristic at place of lambda, you can replace the matrix here. Definitely the matrix will satisfy that characteristic polynomial. So just to see, so A is 1, 2, 3, 4. So then if you consider the determinant of A minus lambda, it means it will become determinant of first element will become 1 minus lambda. There will be no changes in the second position. And in the second row, first element, there is no changes. And second row, second element, it will be 4 minus lambda. So because just you consider determinant of A minus lambda, it will become 1, 2. So just to find out first one A minus lambda, then you can put the matrix determinant to that matrix minus lambda into 1, 0, 0, 1. Whatever order of the matrix will be there, the same order of the identity matrix you have to consider. So once if you multiplied the lambda to this one, means you'll get lambda 0, 0, lambda. And you know how to subtract any two matrix if they are same order, means just to corresponding positions you have to subtract. It will become 2 will be 2 and 3 minus 0 means it will be 3 over minus lambda. So this is the matrix A minus. So now you have to put the determinant to this matrix. So 1 minus lambda into 4 minus lambda. It will become 1 minus lambda into 4 minus lambda minus 2 into 3. So just to simplify this one, 1 into 4 is 4. 1 into minus lambda will become minus lambda, and minus lambda into 4 minus lambda into minus lambda will become plus lambda square minus 2 into 3. 2 into 3 is 6. Just to simplify this one, so in decreasing order you note down this polynomial. Lambda square is the, this is the highest power. Lambda square you first note down. Minus 4 lambda minus lambda, it will become minus 5 lambda. Minus 6 plus 4, it will become minus 2. So this is the required characteristic polynomial of the given matrix 1, 2, 3, 4. So now according to Cayley-Hamilton theorem, what it says, the matrix itself will satisfy the characteristic polynomial. That is, so just you have to replace lambda by A, then you'll get A square minus 5A minus 2I2 equals to 0. In case you want, check this matrix also, whether it is right or not, just to find out the A square first. A square, it will become 1, 2, 3, 4 into 1, 2, 3, 4, right? 1, 2, 3, 4, 1, 2, 3, 4. Just to multiply this matrix. 1, so first row into second, first column. So it will become 1 into 1 is 1, plus 2 into 3 is 6. Next, first row into second column. 1 into 2 is 2, plus 2 into 4 is 8. Next, 3 into 1 is 3. Plus 4 into 3 is 12. Next, 3 into 2 is 6. Plus 4 into 4 is 16. So just to simplify this one, this matrix, this is nothing but A square. It will be 7. So just cross verifying the Kelly-Hamilton theorem. A 10, 2 plus 8 is 10. So this will be 15 and this will be 16 plus 6 means it will be 22. So this is the matrix A square. So similarly, you have to find out minus 5A. Minus 5A means just you have to multiply by minus 5. It will become minus 5A will be equals to the matrix minus 5A will be equals to minus 5 into 1 is minus 5. Minus 5 into 2 is 10. Minus 10. Minus 5 into 3 is minus 15. And minus 5 into 4 is minus 20. So this is the matrix 5A minus 5A. So A square minus 5A means it will become A square minus 5A. So just I will find out the value of A square minus 5A. Later I will consider minus 2. It will become, so 7 minus 5 means it will be 2. And 10 minus 10 will become 0. Next 15 minus 15 means it will be 0. 22 minus 20 means it will be 2. So this is the matrix value for the A square minus 5A expression. So now if you consider 2i, minus 2i means it will be minus 2, 0. Definitely the value will become 0. So here it may be, it's having only power 2, you can find out it easily. But if it is power, is powers are more than 2, that means 3 or more than 3, means it's very difficult to find out the value of that one. So in that case, we can use this Kelly-Hamilton theorem. So this is the main use of the Kelly-Hamilton theorem. Even you can find out the inverse of this matrix by using Kelly-Hamilton theorem. Kelly-Hamilton theorem, you can find out the inverse matrix also. For example, just I'll consider this one only. So this is the polynomial we got one when you expand the determinant of A minus lambda I. So in this one, if you want to find out the A inverse means, what you have to do means just you have to multiply A inverse to this polynomial. So if you multiplied A inverse means it will become A inverse into A square, A inverse into A square minus 5 A inverse A, 5 A inverse A minus 2 A inverse into I, just you can write I, so it will be identity matrix of order 2, which will be equals to 0. So now, any matrix into I means what it will become? What you will get? If you multiplied identity matrix to any matrix means it will become A inverse itself, right? Am I audible, students?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So now if you multiplied A inverse to the I means it will become A inverse itself. Now, A into A inverse. What is the value of A into A inverse? Anybody? What is the value of A into A inverse? What is the value of A into A inverse? So A inverse into A means 1 will be I into A. Now you can just to simplify this one, then you'll get the required value of A inverse. So H equals to 0 means if you shift this one to right hand side means it will be 2A inverse. We know the value of A, IA into A means it will be, once again it will be I, matrix A. A minus 5I means you can find out it easily. A minus 5I means it will become 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. The matrix is 1, 2, 3, 4. Minus 5i means it will become minus of 5, 0, 0, 5. So if you simplify required A inverse, after that you can, you have to cross multiply this two also. So in verification, what is that guarantee means? If you want to verify means just to try this problem. In CALC itself, you will get the same value. 1 minus 5 means it will be minus 2. Divided by 2 means it will become minus 1. So next 2 minus 0 is 2, 2 by 2 means 3 minus 0 is 3, divided by 2 means it will become 3 by 2, 3 by 2. So next 4 minus 5 is minus 1. It will become minus 1 by 2. So this is the required inverse of the matrix 1, 2, 3, 4. Even you can check this one. If you want to cross verify, means you can check inverse of the given matrix 1, 2, 3, 4 in CALC. You will get the same answer. Is it clear? Understood or not? Something you should respond, at least even if you are not getting also, you let me know. And we explain again same thing. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this is the main use of Kelly-Hamilton theorem. So you can find out the value of the any polynomial in terms of matrix, and you can find out the inverse of the matrix also. Next one is how to find out the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. I'll tell
sir,
you
later,
I'll tell the shortcuts also, but you should know what is the traditional method to find out the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. You may solve some questions based on eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Who's that? Just you.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Dear students, the class is going on and I see few students been asking for attendance. So please make sure that you attend the entire class so that you get the benefits out of it. I hope you take it positive, and we request you to be interactive all over the session. So sorry for the interruption, sir, but I just felt few students were interacting and asking for the attendance, which was disturbing the class. So where I felt I could drop a word to it.
Some will end the class for the sake of, after that they will, after giving attendance, give the meeting. Like that students.
Sure, sir.
Okay.
Thank you, students.
So next one, so just you know this method, how to find out the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So only one problem I'm telling. So this method anyway, it will not be applicable to competitive exams, but you should know the method how to find out the eigenvalues and eigenvectors, because there will be no shortcut method for finding the eigenvectors. So you can find out eigenvalues by using shortcut method. So you can implement that one, but in case if they ask us to find out the eigenvectors, means in that case, you should know how to find out the eigenvectors. Okay, for that purpose, just I'm going to explain one problem based on eigenvectors. So as usual, you have to find out the characteristic roots or eigenvalues by considering the equation determinant of A minus lambda I. So if you consider determinant of A minus lambda I, means it will become 3 minus lambda 4, 0 minus 0. 4 minus lambda. If you simplify this one, means you will get lambda square minus 7 lambda plus 12 equals 0. So now for this one, you have to find out the roots. So the roots of this equation will become lambda equals 3 comma 4. Just you can write this one as lambda square minus 3 lambda into minus 3 lambda minus 4 lambda plus 12. So then if you simplify, means you will get the roots of this equation will become 3 comma 4. So these are the eigenvalues, two eigenvalues, 3 and 4 are the eigenvalues of the given matrix 3 minus 4, 0, 4. After finding the eigenvalues, I told you have to consider the matrix A minus lambda I. You have to consider the matrix I into matrix X. So this matrix X is nothing but some non-zero matrix, which you have to equate this one to 0. Once if you solve this equation, matrix A minus lambda into X equals 0, then you will get the values for X. Definitely it will be non-zero values. So that values of the X are nothing but the eigenvectors. So just to try, see the first case. If we put a lambda equals 3, means it will be A minus 3A into X. So now you put the value of A. So value of A minus 3A, you can substitute directly A minus 3A itself. So it will become 3, matrix A is 3, 3 minus 3 means the first row, first element will become 0. Minus 4 minus 0, it will be minus 4 as it is. Next 0 minus 0 means it will be 0 as it is. Next one is 4 minus 3. It will be 1 into xy. These xy values you have to find out. So sometimes you may get unique value, or sometimes you may get some, you can't find out the, what is that x value, y value explicitly. In that case, you have to assume one of the value. Either you may assume x value or y value, that will be fine. So in case if you are not able to find out, in that case you have to find assume. So once if you solve this one, means that will be just you have to multiply 0 into 0 minus 4 into xy, means it will become minus 4y will be equals to 0, one value. And one more, so 0 into 1, y equals 0. Just you are getting the value of y. Just you are getting the value of y. So value of y is 0, but we don't know the value. So value of y is 0, but we are not getting x from this one. But we should find out x also. In that case, you have to assume some x equals k. So by putting x equals any value, k equals some 1, 2, 3, or minus 1, minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, you will get the infinite number of vectors. That's why I told any non-zero vector means that's not the unique. You can find values, you can find out infinite number of eigenvectors. But you will get linearly independent eigenvectors means you will get some finite number. Some definite number of eigenvectors, linearly independent eigenvectors you will get. In case if you want linearly dependent, means you can construct some infinite number of eigenvectors. So same procedure you have to apply for the second matrix, second eigenvalue also. So just you have to put lambda equals 4 in this one, then you will get 4. 3 minus 4 means it will be minus 1. And then minus 4 as it is, 0 as it is, 4 minus 4 means it will be 0. So then you will get one more vector as 0 comma k. So this is the first vector with respect to the eigenvector 3. So in case if you want to find out for 4, means it will be 0 comma 1 into k. So that will be the another eigenvector. So if you consider k equals 1, means you will get 0, 1, 0, 0, 1, 1, 0. These are linearly independent vectors. But after that, if you are considering any vector by putting k equals something, means definitely it will depends on one more vector. That's why you can construct infinite number of eigenvectors, but only finite number or definite number of linearly independent eigenvectors. So that thing also they may ask. So next, so this is a case, second case, just to, you are getting the both values, x and y values, minus 1, minus 4. So this will be the value. So these are the some few properties we have to remember for solving the any problems based on this eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So these properties plays a major role while finding the eigenvalues and eigenvectors. Once if you understood the properties, what these properties saying means, so that property will become shortcut method for finding any solution of any equation. So that's why you should try to remember these properties, because these are only shortcuts for solving any finding eigenvalues or eigenvectors. The first one is the sum of the eigenvalues of a matrix is equal to the trace of the matrix. So trace of the matrix means elements. For example, just consider the matrix 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4. Trace of this matrix is the matrix should be a square matrix. One thing is the matrix should be square matrix. So if you added these two matrix, means it will become the trace of this matrix. So we will indicate it by some TR of A. So if this is the matrix, if you consider this matrix as A as 1, 2, 3, 4, the trace of A will become principal diagonal, sum of the principal diagonal elements. So these are the principal diagonal. 1 plus 4, that will be the 5. So now property, what it's saying, the sum of the eigenvalues, the sum of the eigenvalues will be equals to trace of the matrix. 1 plus 4 will be equals to 5. So just to see the last example better, then you will come to know at least. See here, the trace of this matrix will be what? 7. 3 plus 4 means it will be 7. What we got the, what is that? Eigenvalues also we got 3, 4. the sum of these two also 7. So that is the sum of the eigenvalues is always equals to the trace of the matrix. 1 minute. Sorry for the interruption. I got call one. So what's the first property I'm telling, right? So the sum of the eigenvalues is always equals to the sum of the eigenvalues of a matrix is always equals to the trace of the matrix. So second thing in that second point is the product of eigenvalues is equals to the determinant of the matrix. So just to, so you know, eigenvalues. After that, in case if you want to find out the determinant, means even you can find out your determinant by using this eigenvalues. So the product of the eigenvalues will be equals to the determinant of the matrix, and sum of the eigenvalues will be equals to the trace of. Consider this matrix, whatever we solved for this one, 3, 4 are the eigenvalues. So if you consider the multiplication of these two, means it will be 12. So just consider this matrix 3 - 4, 0, 4 means the determinant of this matrix will be 12. So that is the determinant of the matrix is always equals to the product of the eigenvalues. So these are the two points, key points you should remember, and these two key points will place a major role while finding the eigenvalues or while finding the determinant of the matrix or while finding the inverse of the matrix. So that's why just to try to remember these two key points. Next one is A and A transpose have the same eigenvalues but different eigenvectors. So the main thing is the eigenvalues of the matrix and its transpose matrix is same, but the eigenvectors will not be same. In case if they given some matrix with its eigenvalues and if they asked us to find out the eigenvalues of the transpose matrix, then no need to worry about anything. Directly you can write the same eigenvalues by using this property. That is, the matrix and its transpose matrix will be having same eigenvalues, but there will be no same eigenvectors, and there will be no question based on that eigenvectors for the transpose. Only if they want to ask any question, means they will ask. For example, so just to consider the last problem, 3, 4, 0, 4. 3 - 4, 0, 4. The eigenvalues of the matrix are 3, 4. Then the eigenvalues of the transpose of the given matrix, like that they will ask. Okay. So this, just you keep it in your mind, the transpose matrix and matrix will be having same eigenvalues. Eigenvalues of a idempotent matrix. Idempotent, what is the idempotent matrix? What is the idempotent matrix? We already discussed, right? Anybody? What is the idempotent matrix? Everything, if you are remember, if you are not ready to remember, means no use simply attending class. You should try to remember little bit definitions, little bit properties, and little bit shortcuts. Then only it will be helpful. Idempotent matrix we discussed in first class itself. Even in next class I revised also. Anybody, what is the idempotent matrix?
A square equals A,
correct. So for that idempotent matrix, the eigenvalues of the idempotent matrix, it will be either 0 only two choices, idempotent matrix. If the matrix is idempotent, then its eigenvalues always will be zero or unity. Unity means it will be one, zero or one. Next, eigenvalues of identity matrix. If you consider identity matrix, means it always one only. There will be no other eigenvalues. So only thing is, eigenvalues of an identity idempotent matrix are either zero or unity. So this is ARER, and eigenvalues of the identity matrix are unity always. Next thing, if lambda is an eigenvalue of a matrix, then corresponding eigenvector x is not unique. That thing already I told. We have infinite number of eigenvectors corresponding to single eigenvalue. Next, if lambda 1, lambda 2, so on, lambda n be distinct eigenvalues of n cross n matrix, then the corresponding eigenvectors are forms a linearly independent. So if their eigenvalues are different, means their eigenvectors forms a linearly independent set. In case if you consider twice, means it will not be linearly independent. Next one is, this one is not important. So eigenvalues of a real symmetric matrix are real. If it is Hermitian matrix or symmetric matrix, real symmetric matrix, always you will get the real eigenvalues for that one. So this thing, in case if they given one real symmetric matrix and if they asked to find out the eigenvalues, means, so going through the proper method, traditional method, means it will take some at least two minutes time minimum. So in case if you remember this property, means you can use this property. So in that case, what they will do now, they will give one choice as real entries and remaining will be imaginary entries. So in that case, just you have to pick the real entries, which one is having real values, that thing you can select. Next, eigenvalues of a real skew symmetric matrix. Skew symmetric matrix. Symmetric matrix means real. Skew symmetric means either it will be zero or purely imaginary. Purely imaginary means it should be I or 2I or 3I, like this. It may be purely imaginary. Just to keep it in your mind, eigenvalues of a symmetric matrix is real, and eigenvalues of a symmetric skew symmetric matrix is either zero or imaginary. Next, in purely imaginary means there will be no real part in that one. It's having, for example, x plus I, y plus 2i. So in this one, you already studied complex analysis. You know what's the real part and imaginary part. This one is real part, and this two is nothing but imaginary part. So purely imaginary means this one will not be there. Only 2i will be there. So that is nothing but purely imaginary. Next, eigenvalues of a real orthogonal matrix. If it is orthogonal matrix, means it's always absolute value. So it will be only one. There will be no absolute value, means it may be minus one, but the what's the absolute, the mod of that one will become one. If it is identity matrix, it will be always, it will be one. If it is idempotent matrix, it will be either zero or one. If it is real skew symmetric matrix, means it will be either it will be zero or purely imaginary. If it is real symmetric matrix, means always it will be real eigenvalues. So next one, this one is also important, 10th point. If lambda is an eigenvalue of a non-singular matrix A, then, so I told already, transpose matrix will be having same eigenvalue, but inverse matrix, the eigenvalue of the inverse will be 1 by lambda. Just reciprocal of the eigenvalue will become eigenvalue of the inverse matrix. And adjoint of A, the eigenvalue of the adjoint of A will become determinant of A by lambda. So because we know that A inverse will be equal to adjoint of A by determinant of A. So if you cross multiplied and simplified, means you will get determinant of A by adjoint of A equals to a determinant of A into A inverse. So A inverse means the eigenvalue of the A inverse will become 1 by lambda. That's why the eigenvalue of the adjoint of A is always determinant of A by lambda. For this one, but based on this 10th property, there will sometimes direct question. If you remember this property, you can, without thinking, even 0.05 seconds are enough. Within 5 seconds, you can select the answer. Okay. So next one, if lambda is an eigen LFA matrix, they missed the lambda here, it should be lambda. If lambda is an eigen LFA matrix, then lambda power m is an eigenvalue of a power m. And k lambda will be eigenvalue of k a. And lambda plus or minus k power m means it will be a plus or minus k. So just in this one, what you have to remember means these two, first two. So for example, in case if they given to find out the eigenvalue of a power 100 means it's very difficult to find out the a power 100 manually, right? So in that case, what you can make means just you have to that matrix. After finding the eigenvalue of that matrix, just you can find out lambda power m. That is, the eigenvalue power 100 will become the required eigenvalue of the matrix A power 100. So in case if they ask to find out the eigenvalue of the any power matrix, in that case you have to use this property. So next one is K lambda. K lambda means if it is matrix is multiplied by any constant means, so we can take that constant outside, and for the remaining thing you can find out the eigenvalue. At the end moment you can find out, you can multiply eigenvalue with the constant. Next one, if lambda be an eigenvalue of a non-singular, this one I already told here. So these are the few properties you have to remember. So just 1 minute, take 1 minute of time and go through these properties. So just I'll open this one. So just all of you go through these properties and try to remember these properties, then only you can solve the questions based on this. Take a 5 minutes of time and try to remember. All of you go through these properties and try to remember. Are you remembered? Once if you remembered, I'll move on to problem. So in this one, first one, second one, third one, rarely they will ask based on third one. After that, fifth one is also not that much important. The seventh, eighth, ninth, tenth. So these are the important, and 11th. Shall I move on to problems?
Yes, sir.
Just to see the first question, is it visible question? Is it visible, guys? Question? For this also, we'll take this much time, huh? Huh? Is it visible now?
Yes, sir.
So just to see the first question. If the eigenvalues of the given matrix are minus 4 and b minus 1, then find b. So otherwise I'll try this problem. So next problem onwards you can solve it. So just to remember the matrix and eigenvalues. I'll move on to smart board. So just to remember matrix and eigenvalues. Anyone of you, can you tell me what is the matrix? What is the matrix? Am I audible, students?
Yes, sir.
Otherwise, I have again, that's why. Two B three minus one, right? Two B three minus one. They are given that the eigenvalues are minus 4 and B minus 1. So now we have to find out the value of B. So just to see, you have to find out the eigenvalues of, you can substitute that one in the B, then you will get the value of B. First find out A minus lambda I, matrix A minus lambda I, it will be 2B 3 minus 1. So this is the matrix A minus lambda I means lambda 0 0 lambda. So this is the matrix lambda. So just to subtract lambda in matrix A, it will become 2 minus lambda. B minus 0 means B, 3 minus 0 means 3, minus 1 to minus lambda. So this is the matrix A minus lambda. So our aim is what? You have to find out the eigenvalues. Just to consider determinant of A minus lambda I, which is equals to 0. So that implies determinant of 2 minus lambda B, 3 minus 1 minus lambda, which is equals to 0. Now you have to expand this determinant. It will become 2 minus lambda into minus 1 minus lambda minus 3b equals 0. Just you have to simplify this one. So it will become 2 into minus 1 means it will be, I'll write the first lambda square. Minus lambda into minus lambda will be lambda square. And minus 1 into minus lambda means plus lambda. 2 into minus lambda means minus 2 lambda. It will become minus lambda. Is it right? Next, 2 into minus 1 is minus 2. Minus 3b, which is equals to 0. Lambda square minus lambda minus 2 minus 3b, which is equals to 0. We are already given that lambda equals minus 4, one value, and one more b minus 1. Just to substitute lambda equals minus 4 in this equation, so then we'll get minus 4 square, minus of minus 4 will become plus 4, minus 2, minus 3b, which is equals to 0. So minus 4 square means it will be 16, plus 4 minus 2 means it will become 2, minus 3b, which is equals to 0. This implies 16 plus 2 means 18. 18 equals 3b. Just I shifted to minus 3b to right hand side. So now you can cross multiply this 3. So that implies b will be equals to 6. Our aim is what? Just you have to find out the b value. So that's why no need, even if you are not considering the b minus 1 also, we can get the value of b. So this is enough because our aim is to find. Is it clear?
Yes, sir.
So just to see the PDF now. I close that whiteboard. What is the answer?
6.
What is the option?
D, sir.
Right. So the value of the eigenvalue, the value of B is 6. So like this, you can find out. In case if you are able to apply the shortcut method, you can apply. For this one, there will be, you can't apply because one more thing. Can I, 1 minute, I'll think. Just 2 minus 1 is 1. Minus 4. I'll tell the shortcut method for this also, just to remember whatever we got. Even without finding also you can find out. So just I'll tell that method, shortcut method. So what we got? So lambda equals 6.
B is equals to 6 now.
B equals 6, 1 minute. B equals 6 we got. I will tell the shortcut method how we can solve this one B without finding the value of eigenvalues. Okay, B. So just what you have to do means the values are, options are 3, 4, 5. Keep it in your mind. 3, 4, 5, 6. So just you, we know the property. What's the property? Trace of A. Trace of A is equals to sum of the eigenvalues. Is equals to sum of the eigenvalues. So even you can use this property to find out the value of B also. So sum of the eigenvalues is nothing but what? Trace of A. Trace of A means just you have to add the principal diagonal elements. What's the addition of that one? It'll become 2 minus 1 elements are. 2 minus 1 means it will be equals to 1. 1 equals to sum of the eigenvalues. Sum of the eigenvalues. And they are given that the sum of eigenvalues. The eigenvalues are what? Minus 4, one thing, and one more thing is B minus 1. Right. So just to simplify this one, you will get 1. Minus 4 minus 1 means it will be minus 5. If you shift it this side means it will be plus 5, which is equals to B. That implies B will be equals to 6. So without finding the eigenvalues, you can find out the value of B. Understood?
Yes, sir.
Any doubt in this one?
Anybody? No.
Okay, I'll move on to the next problem then. Second question, you see, if lambda is the eigenvalue of a n by n matrix, then the eigenvalue of a power m. So anybody can answer this one? This is direct question only. If you know the property means you can, without thinking anything, you can directly tell the answer. You can select the answer. Will be the answer. In case if you want, I will open that properties again.
Lambda to the power m.
Lambda to the power m. Only one is responding, others not. No, not at all responding only. Are you getting or not others? Arshita, Meghana, Nikhil, Ranjit, Prithvi, Pavan. At least whatever I'm explaining, that thing you are getting, Pavan?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So on what basis you are telling Kirti, so the eigenvalue of A power M is lambda power M?
Property, sir. Lambda M is if an eigenvalue of A of M, then we say it is. If the eigenvalue of matrix A, then we say lambda M is eigenvalue of A of M, no, sir.
Yeah, right. So that is the 10th property, I think 10th or 11th property. First one, right? So if lambda is the eigenvalue of any matrix, then lambda power m will be the eigenvalue of the A power m. So based on that property, without solving anything, you can select this one, lambda power m is the right answer. Next one, find the eigenvalues of the following matrix. 0343006200009 matrix. So just to try to find out this one, after that I will tell the shortcut method, because directly if I am telling means you won't think only. Once if you know the how much time it will take as usual method, then you will come to know how much shortcut methods are important. So just to try to find out the eigenvalues of this one. So once you get the answer, let me know. Here you have to consider 4x4 identity matrix. And it's very easy also, even by traditional method, whatever we follow, that method also, by using that method also, it will be very easy to find out. Once if you get the answer, let me know. Anybody got the answer? Are you solving or not? By saying 4x4 matrix, you afraid or what? Kirtana? What is the answer? My audible students, at least you should respond something simply. I think your giants, you are giant and they are not listening also. Answer the attendance.
Sir, solve the problem.
What, Kirtana?
Solve the problem, sir. I'm not getting the answer.
Is it? So you are expanding the determinant?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'll tell one method. So just to consider the matrix.
Okay.
1x2703. For this one, you find out the eigenvalues.
This is shortcut, sir.
Shortcut. No, not shortcut. You'll come to know how we can find out. Because 4x4 means it's difficult to expand the determinant, no?
Yes, sir.
Others, are you getting idea or not? I'm not at all trying only. Omkar?
Yes, sir.
Are you trying? You're not audible. I think you told for answer, attendance, huh? Yes, sir.
Sir.
Hmm?
No, sir.
Okay. Okay, I'll explain other problems by taking some general example. Later, you only can tell this one answer. Okay?
D is the answer, sir. D or C?
No, I want exact answer. You, if you are telling two options, means this is not, multiple choice. Only one option is correct, not two. In some exams, it will be like that. It may having only one option is right, or two, or three, or all four also. That also possibility will be there. In that choice, you can think about D or C or like that.
Yes, sir.
Just to consider the matrix. One matrix. Sum 1, 2, 0, 3. So what we call this matrix? Anybody? What's the name of this matrix? What we can call this one? What we can call? What matrix it is? 1, 2, 0, 3. Is it diagonal matrix?
No, sir.
No, then which type?
No, sir.
Which type of matrix it is?
Transpose of matrix, sir.
Not transpose. So I'm written only one matrix. Then how you'll come to know it is transpose of matrix? matrix?
Upper triangular, sir.
Yes, exactly. So this is the upper triangular matrix. In upper triangular, what? So all the elements below the principal diagonal. This is the principal diagonal. So below this one, all the elements should be zero. For example, 3x3 matrix means 1, 2, 3, 0. This may be positive, some 3, and it will be some 4, 0, 0, 2. So this is also one of the upper triangular matrix. So in this one, just I'll find out the eigenvalues for the first one. 1, 2, 0, 3. So because this is the 2x2 matrix, that's why it will be very easy to find out the eigenvalues. So I'll consider the matrix A minus lambda I. Matrix A minus lambda I, which is equals to 1, 2, 0, 3 minus, this is minus lambda 0, 0, lambda. Right. So which will be equals to 1 minus lambda 2. This will be 0. This will be 3 minus lambda. Just to find out the determinant of this one, which will be equals to 1 minus lambda into 3 minus lambda. Is it right? Is it right?
Yes, sir.
So if we equate this one to 0, means what will be the value of lambda? Lambda equals 1 and lambda equals 3. These are the two eigenvalues. So now by seeing the eigenvalues in the matrix, where those elements are present, 1 and 3?
Principal diagonal elements.
Principal diagonal elements. So that means the property is, if the matrix is upper triangular, then the diagonal elements are nothing but the eigenvalues of the matrix. Is it clear? Okay. If the matrix is upper triangular or lower triangular or diagonal element, diagonal matrix. Okay. For all three cases, it may be upper triangular,
lower triangular,
or it may be lower triangular, or it may be diagonal matrix. Diagonal matrix means we know that the diagonal element should be non-zero and all other elements should be zero. In all these three cases, the eigenvalues will be principal. The eigenvalues are nothing but the principal diagonal elements. Without solving this one, anything, so actually they are not mentioned this property in the whatever they are given properties, main property only. So principal diagonal elements are nothing but the eigenvalues of the upper triangular or lower triangular or diagonal matrix. It may be diagonal matrix means it may consist scalar matrix as well as identity matrix or unit matrix. For all these, the diagonal elements will become the eigenvalues of the matrix. Is it clear now?
Yes, sir.
So now I will come to that problem. So now we can think how much time will take for answering that question. Now you tell me the answer.
B, sir.
B is the right answer, right? So if you know that property means you can do it easily. That's why I told one hint. You have to select or you have to consider just a 2x2 matrix. For that purpose, I told. Is it clear to everybody?
Yes, sir.
Just to note down. So the eigenvalues of the upper triangular or lower triangular or diagonal matrix is nothing but the principal diagonal elements. No need to worry about anything if it is upper triangular or diagonal matrix. Directly you can select the diagonal elements of that matrix. That will become the required eigenvalues of the given matrix. Shall I move on to next question?
Yes, sir.
So next one is, if ABA n cross n matrix, then which of the following is true? The product of the eigenvalue of A is equal to determinant of A. The product of the eigenvalues of A is the sum of the squares of the eigenvalues is equal to determinant of A. The product of the eigenvalues of A is double of the determinant of A. So which is right one? This is the property. No need to solve anything. Which is right option? At least you should write what is that properties and all you have to note down in your notebook. Then it will be helpful. Otherwise, simply if you are listening, means no use only. Anybody?
What happened? If the eigenvalues are determined on.
Eigenvalue?
Is linearly independent.
Linear, here there is no linear independent only, right? Determinant of A will be equals to what? First property itself, this is. While explaining, I told directly like this, nothing else I told.
Yes, sir. A is your answer.
A is the right answer. The sum of the eigenvalues is nothing but what? Trace of the matrix.
Yes, sir.
The product of the eigenvalues of the matrix is nothing but what? Determinant of the matrix. That's why A is the right option. The product of the eigenvalues of A is equal to determinant of A. This is the right answer. Okay, this is a direct question only. No need to solve anything. Now, this one. Will you find out A square and then find out the I think nobody is ready to focus. Explaining, I told you this property is important. Like this only it will come.
B is the option, sir.
D is the option, right? Based on, so even we solved one question also based on this, right? So this question, that question are same. Here they are given the value, but here they are given general value. For matrix A is lambda is the matrix, so eigenvalue means the lambda power m will become eigenvalue of the A power m. So here they are given eigenvalues of A are 115. A square means just you have to square this. 1 square is 1. 1 square is once again 1. 5 square is 25. That means D is the right option. Understood? Others, are you getting or not? You should respond at least. If you are not getting also, you tell me. So I'm not the host. ESC, somebody is because recording they want, that's why they, somebody is host. I can't let in anybody now. He has to accept the students. Somebody put message in chat box. Who's that? Harshita. Understood this question?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Next. This one, if lambda is an eigenvalue of A, non-singular matrix A, then which of the following is an eigenvalue of adjoint of A? So even this is also property they mentioned. If you remember that property, you can directly select. Otherwise, just to consider formula. From that also, you can, without remembering that one, you can. Because anyway, you remember the A inverse formula. From that you can find out.
D, sir.
D is the right option, correct. Others? Others, anybody? Yeah, at least you should respond, guys. Simply if you are listening means no use only. Suhas, I'm audible. 17CV052.
Yes, sir.
Understood how it will be determinant of A by lambda? Have you noted down the properties? Whatever I told, 10 properties. Have you noted down? Have you noted down or not?
Yes, sir.
Others? This is the main drawback. At least if you noted down those properties, means by seeing that one, you can select this option directly. I'll tell how to remember without remembering that property. So, but you should remember little bit other important properties. Then only you can do this one. See, without remembering anything means it will be difficult. In case if you are not exactly remember whatever the adjoint of A means, you can solve like this. I'll tell the method. What is the inverse formula? A inverse equals what?
Adjoint of A by...
Adjoint of A by determinant of A. Okay, so now our aim is what? Adjoint of A we have to find out. Adjoint of A will become A inverse into determinant of A, which is equals to adjoint of A. So what they given? A is a matrix having eigenvalue lambda. So one of the properties says that if A is a matrix of eigenvalue lambda, then the eigenvalue of the A inverse, what it will become? What is the eigenvalue of the A inverse? 1 by lambda. So just to substitute this value, then it will become determinant of A by lambda will become the eigenvalue of the matrix adjoint of A. So here one property of anyway. Who's that man?
Huh?
Suhas? Yes, sir. If you want to talk there, means you should mute and talk, man. Understood?
Yes, sir.
One minute. So I'll move on to next question. Is this one you try? If matrix A equals this much, find the value of A cube plus 12A. For this also, shortcut is there, but you try your method, whatever you are coming into your mind, that thing you try by applying that one. At the end, I'll tell how to find out it easily. So which one you can apply this one? For this one, Kelly-Hamilton theorem. Just try it, just to find out the polynomial. I think so many are waiting for attendance. Just so they are not responding only. Ranjitvi, I'm calling attendance. Ranjitvi absent. Shankar Chauhan.
Yes, sir.
For attendance, you will answer. For other thing, you won't open your.
Sir, which department is going on, sir?
What, which department?
Sir, you're calling out from Zoom class, attending participants' name or department?
You're not responding only enough for everything. That's why I'm calling just like that. Still, I'm taking attendance. Just I'm checking whether you are listening or not, at least.
No, sir. I'm listening on the previous class also. You told like this, sir.
No, no, no. At least just I'm checking just by calling some names. Because in this online, na, simply if you joined and if you kept somewhere means it will show you joined here. But if you are not listening means no use only.
Sir, one more doubt you have, sir.
Yes.
Sir, sir, they told today is October 7th is a GATE last exam, sorry. Like exam fee.
For applying, yeah.
Like, I have to pay my own amount and apply or some fund will be given from college, sir?
For that thing, better you contact your Prerana coordinators in your department. Coordinators will be there, na?
Okay, sir.
So contact them, they will give the they will tell the details.
Okay, sir.
Okay. At least you try by traditional method. That will also, by that method also you will get the answer. After getting polynomial, just to replace lambda by a, then you will get the required answer. One thing. If anybody got the shortcut methods, that also fine. Only you can tell that shortcut method, or even by traditional method also you can find out the solution. Shall I start? If you are not getting, means I'll start the solution.
Yes, sir.
Just to tell me matrix. Just to take snap or just to remember matrix. I'll stop share this one in this one. Can you tell me matrix?
Zero. 4 - 1.
1 minute. 4 - 1.
-104.
-104.
4 - 1, 0.
4 - 1, 0. So this is the matrix A. What we have to find out?
A² + 12A.
A² + 2A. 2A, na?
1, 2.
1, 2, 12A. Is it right?
Yes, sir.
Not A² - A³. Right? So because it is 2 3 by 3 matrix, now it should be A³.
Okay, sir.
A³ or A² only? Okay, let it be A³. Wait 1 minute, I'll check in PDF. No, it's A³ only. So just to find out, first determinant of A minus lambda. First, so directly I'll write the value minus lambda. 0 minus lambda means minus lambda. 4 minus 1 minus 1 minus lambda. 4 minus 1 minus lambda. So just to expand this determinant, minus lambda. N minus lambda into lambda square minus into minus will become plus 4. Next minus 4 into, so minus 1 into minus lambda means it will be lambda. Minus will become plus 4. Next consider minus 1. Minus 1 into 1 minus 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 will become plus 4 lambda. Just to simplify this one, we'll get minus lambda cube minus 4 lambda minus 4 lambda plus minus into minus 16 minus 1 plus minus 1 into minus 4 lambda. So I made mistake, I think. So this is the 16, right? Not plus 16, it is minus 16. So second term, minus 4 into minus 1 into minus lambda means it will be plus lambda, and 4 into 4 means it will be 16, minus 16. I made mistake. So this means it will become minus into minus will become plus 64. So remaining thing, everything is right only. So just to simplify this one, now minus lambda cube minus 4 lambda minus 4 lambda minus 4 lambda means it will be minus 12 lambda. 64 minus 1 means it will be plus 63. Okay, so now we just to shift these two, lambda cube 12 lambda to right hand side, left hand side, so which is equal to 0. If you shift it to opposite side means it will be lambda cube plus 12 lambda, which is equals to 63. Is it right?
Yes, sir.
So replace lambda by a. It will become a cube plus 12a, which is equals to, if you are replacing the lambda by a means you have to multiply constant by I. So 63i is the right answer. So 1 minute, just I'll open that one. After that, once again, I'll come into this whiteboard. Which is the option?
B.
B is the right option. All of you understood, this is the traditional method. By using traditional method also, in 1 minute, you can find out the answer. I'll tell the shortcut next. So at least, have you understood this one, how to find out?
Yes, sir.
Okay, by using Kelly-Hamilton theorem, we got the value of a cube plus 12a as 63i. So now I will tell the shortcut method for that. So just to keep it in your mind, the coefficient of constant will be determinant of the matrix. So here I is nothing but constant, okay? So coefficient of identity or constant term in the polynomial. So this is the polynomial means lambda cube minus 12 lambda plus 63 equals 0. This is the lambda means. So this 63 will be determinant of the matrix. Or in case if you consider the in terms of matrix by using Kelly-Hamilton theorem, if you consider this one means the, what's that term? Coefficient of the identity matrix will be equals to determinant. So just you have to find out the determinant of it to get the value of this one. So what it will become? 0, 4, minus 1. So just to simplify this one, 4 into, it will become minus 1 into 0, 0. This one will become minus 16. So next one is minus 1 into plus 1. Minus 1 into plus 1, right? So this is minus 4, right? So it will become 64 minus 1, which is equals to 63. Is it right? Understood or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so this is the shortcut method, but what thing happened, something? Because they are already given lambda cube plus 12a, a cube plus 12a they given. So that means that's understood that a square will be 0, one thing. So in case if they given a cube plus 12a square means, in that case you can't apply the shortcut method because it may be having function, what's that, the matrix A also, that also it may be there having. So if the, in the option, by seeing the option, you can judge whether you can apply the shortcut method or not. Okay. So if it is not having any matrix A in terms of matrix A, if it is having only in terms of identity matrix means, so in that case, just to remember, the coefficient of the identity matrix will be equals to the determinant of the given matrix. That method you can directly apply and you can get the answer. So next one, if to 0, 1, minus 1, 0, then A has, tell me the answer for this one. This is also, if you remember the properties, you can tell it directly, or without remembering the property also, you can tell the answer exactly by solving, because it is 2 by 2 matrix. If it is 3 by 3 matrix means it will take more time. But you should try to be helpful. Anybody got the answer? We are noted down the, what's that? Properties means just to go through those properties, you may get idea which property you can apply for this one. Any idea? what we can apply for this one, even if you are finding out it by using a normal method, the by that method also you can find it. Why I am explaining both the method means, in case if you are not able to remember the properties or shortcut method means, in that case, even by using the traditional method also you can find out the solution. That's why I am telling you both. If you remember the traditional method means, you can save the time. Otherwise it will take more time. That is the difference. Shankar Chavan, understood. So are you getting the answer? So by the time I'll take the attendance, just to tell me. From EC, just to tell your name from EC. Your voice is not clear. Sucharita.
Sucharita also, sir.
Sucharita, then Harshita. Harshita. Next.
Sir, Varun, sir.
Yes, next. After Varun.
Sir, Varun, sir, Varun.
Varun, over. Sucharita, Varun, Harshita. Only three from ECE. Next from Tribali.
Sir Nikhil.
So Meghna.
Meghna IL.
Nanesh.
Sir Shankar John.
Shankar Chavan.
Sir Nikhil.
Nikhil Kumar D.
Yes, sir. Sir Shankar Chavan.
Shankar Chavan over.
Sir Danish.
Ganesh Nak, yes. Next. So I'll confirm. From the Tribali, Nikhil, Ganesh Nak, Shankar Chavan.
Yes, sir. Meghna, sir.
Yeah, yeah, Meghna over. Next from CSE. From CSE. Nobody? Civil?
Kirtana, sir.
Kirtana.
122, sir.
Om Kalyan.
122.
Omkar, sir.
Pawan Kalyan.
Yes, sir.
Yes. Next, anybody?
Omkar, sir.
Omkar.
Suhas, sir.
1 minute, 1 minute. Omkar Suhas. Suhas M.
Yes, sir.
Anybody else? So I'll confirm from civil. Kirtana, Suhas, Omkar, Pawan Kalyan, and Lalital Mohan. CV 122. Okay. Next from mechanical.
Sir, Ranjit, sir.
Mechanical Ranjit.
Sir, Vignesh also was there, sir, but he's technical problem, sir.
Vignesh Kumar. What technical problem?
Sir, he was there from the beginning, sir. Just now his phone got switched off. He messaged from one more phone, sir.
Okay. But it's showing his name here.
He was a participant, sir, but he left off.
Anybody else from IS? Anybody? From IS? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. Exactly. Anybody got the idea for this problem? What type of matrix it is? What type of matrix? Is it symmetric?
Skew symmetric.
Skew symmetric. At the beginning I told, I'll open that also to note down. That is the problem. Option C, Kirtana. Option C is right only, Kirtana. 1 minute, I'll open that PDF. So just to see this one, 8-1, what it says property? What it says? Eigenvalues of a real skew symmetric matrix are always either zero or purely imaginary. Purely imaginary means there will be no real part. So that means it will be having only on C. That means on set of complex numbers, on set of real numbers, there will be no eigenvalue for that matrix, skew symmetric matrix. Are you getting? Or this is the shortcut method. I'll tell the traditional method. What's the -1, 0. Right, so this is the matrix. If you consider the A minus lambda, it means determinant of A minus lambda, which will be equals to lambda minus lambda 1 minus 1 minus lambda. So it will become lambda square equals to 0. Plus 1 equals to 0 means lambda square equals minus 1. Lambda square equals minus 1 means lambda is what? Plus or minus I. So I is the eigenvalue of the matrix. I is the eigenvalue means this is the imaginary. So that means I belongs to numbers. It doesn't belong to set of reals, right? So that means it will be having eigenvalues over C, but not R. Is it clear? So which option is correct? One minute. Is it visible PDF?
Yes, sir.
Okay, which is right? Right option. Both over R and C is not right choice, because over R there will be I is not belongs to R. That's why R is over R, but not R is also wrong option. Neither R over C means this is also not right option. C is the right option, where R and C are representing the set of reals and complex numbers. So next one you try. So you already know the shortcut method. So within 1 minute, if you are able to answer means, then I will be happy because you know the shortcut method. So I told the characteristic polynomial, the constant term will be equals to determinant of the matrix. The same shortcut method you have to use here also. Just to try to find out the determinant. After getting determinant, be ready. Anybody got the determinant value? Finding determinant also will take this much time. In this one, definitely see D will not be the right option. Only three options. Out of three options, you have to select right one. So that value will be equals to determinant. So that's according to the shortcut method. Otherwise, it's very difficult to find out the determinant of A minus lambda I for the 4x4 matrix. Shall I start? If you are not getting, I'll do. Shall I start or will you try? Do you want some more time?
Start, sir.
Okay. Can you help me to write down the matrix? Anybody?
1 1 2 6 5
2 6 5 true for data?
Yes, so 7, 6.
7? 6?
17 minus 10.
17 minus 10. Next?
Minus 11. 0.
0.
1, 2.
1, 2. So our aim is what? You have to find out the determinant of this one. The determinant of this one will become the coefficient of identity matrix or constant term of the characteristic polynomial. So in the determinant properties, we know that any two rows are identical means what's the value of the determinant? Anybody? I'll repeat once. If any two rows are identical, then the value of the determinant is? If you are not ready to remember the properties, means it very difficult. If two rows are identical, means what's the value of the determinant? So just to consider one example, 1, 2, 1, 2. What's the determinant value of this one?
0.
This is equals to 0. In any determinant, if two rows are identical, means definitely it will be 0. So, and if any row, if it is constant multiple of any constant, if it is multiple of any constant, then you can write it as, if this is the matrix, then determinant of A, we can write that one as that constant into remaining matrix. So in this second row, you see, so it is constant multiple of 2. We can write that one as 1, 2, 6, 5, 2 into 1, 2, 6, 5, 7, 6, 20, minus 10. So this will be minus 11, 0, 1, 2. So now, act or sin. Right?
Yeah.
R1 and R2, the determinant of this one will be what? 2 into 0, which is equals to 0. Is it easy? You are finding 4 by 4 determinant, huh? Expanding? Or what? Kirtana, you also didn't get the answer.
Parts, but then I was not sure if it is right or wrong.
Repeat once, Kirtana.
Got the answer, sir, but then I thought somebody would say, so I didn't say anything.
Okay. So many already left the meeting. Huh? If this is the case, means then I have to extend simply. Otherwise, I'll send the remaining questions. Few more questions are there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5, 6. 6 questions are there. Okay. So you type those questions. Otherwise, if you are interested, then I'll explain, because already the entries, meeting, participants are only 11. 11 in 3 means only 8 are there. Okay. I'll end the session better. I'll send the PDF just to go through the remaining questions and the solution of those questions, okay?
If you have doubts, sir, we'll post it in the group, sir.
If you have doubts, yeah, you can post in the group.
Okay, sir.
I'll tell the options. You can note down those options and you can try. If you are not getting, you can post that time.
Okay, sir.
Okay. I'll tell from last one, then it will be fine for me, because I noted just this number. So this one, last one, just should write L. So for this one, C is the right option.
Okay.
Okay. So last but one, that is 40th question. So for this one, D is the right option. 39th, this one is third. Huh? Yeah. So these two are actually, this is not included in this one. Next one, the characteristic roots. This one, D is the right option. None of these. Next one, for this one, C is the right option. From last, this is the fifth one. And for this one, which are the following eigenvectors? So for this one, A is the right option. I think this is the question we are going to solve. So from up to here, we already solved. Okay. So just to try, if you are not getting, even you can put message. Otherwise, I'll any problem if you face so much difficult means I'll explain in next class.
Okay, sir.
One more thing for the next class, just to prepare calculus. What is that limit, continuity, differentiability? So just how much possible, whenever you'll get the free time, that time you just to give concepts. Just to Google it. Just you'll get the notes if you want. Continuity, differentiability, integrability. Based on that, I'll discuss. Okay.
Okay, sir.
So you can leave meeting.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you.